Looking for a car that can handle the city streets and a weekend getaway and do it in style? Well, this might be the ticket. This is the 2025 Mini Countryman ALL4. What's it like? Buckle up, my friends. Let's go for a drive. I'm your host, Brian Max, racer, lover of driving fast, fun things. And on this channel, you get reviews for drivers from drivers. 2025 marks the year when there's an all new generation of Minis. We've tried the Cooper S. This is the Countryman S in all-wheel drive specification. That's why they call it ALL4. And before we get into what this is like to drive, let's have a look at it in a little more depth. The Countryman is the biggest of Minis, and to some people it's not so mini, but indeed it is. Just look around. It is very much on brand for a Mini and true to the ethos of what Mini is in 2025. It's all new inside and out. It is much bigger inside. The interior is a game-changing redesign, including the big central OLED screen, but most importantly, there's a big bump in power. The engine's a turbocharged 2-liter 4-cylinder. It makes 241 horsepower and 295 pounds of torque. The transmission's a 7-speed dual-clutch automatic. This is all-wheel drive. Steering is electrically assisted. Suspension uses McPherson struts at the front, multi-link at the rear, and adaptive dampers are optional. Wheels and tires are 18s, 19s, or 20s. This one's rocking the 20s. Towing capacity is about 3,500 pounds. And curb weight is not so mini. It weighs 3,777 pounds in this specification.
Did you know that 80% of you are not subscribed? Yes, it's true. 80% of you are not subscribed. I checked the data. So if you like the content on this channel, do me a solid. Hit that subscribe button. Make sure you like this. And if you want to support the channel, please hit up our merch store. Links here, links below. Lots of great stuff for driving enthusiasts like us, including our very popular line of Save the Manuals merch. Now back to your regularly scheduled episode.
This is an all-new design for 2025, so we've got this all-new interior, which we've seen in the new Cooper S, so it is very modern Mini here, but the fundamentals are spot on. Great seat, very supportive, very comfortable, highly adjustable. This does have Mini synthetic leather, but it is high grade. I actually can't complain about it. Really dig the seat, though. It's very comfortable, very supportive, even over long distances, and plenty of adjustment in the seat and the steering column to get very comfortable. And there's a tremendous amount of headroom here. It's absolutely ridiculous. Love the shape and the size of the steering wheel. One thing I didn't mention in the Cooper S episode recently was this third spoke on the steering wheel is a bit of a like a nylon fabric thing. It's a very, very cool touch. First time I've ever seen this in an automobile. Really dig the shape and the size of the steering wheel. It just feels great in your hands. Ergonomically, this is new Mini, so we do have the big OLED screen here and the heads-up display. I kind of like this in a lot of ways. Some ways, I'm not a big fan of it. For example, turn signals. Turn signal indicator is here on the top of the screen. I'd much rather it be here in the heads-up display, but otherwise, the heads-up display has all of the information I need when I'm driving normally, and I can actually see it with my polarized sunglasses, so well done. Mini. But yeah, there's a few too many things in this screen. For example, there are the climate controls, and that would be easier to deal with if it were separate buttons, switches, dials, whatever the case is. For me, I use it on Apple CarPlay and love the way it works on CarPlay. On the other hand, the navigation system does use some augmented reality that is very helpful when you're driving in a big city like I am, where you're unfamiliar with certain roads, and the augmented reality embedded into the navigation system works extremely well. The fundamental ergonomics, definitely unique to Mini. The start-stop switch is this little switch here, and the shifter is this switch here, and you've got the experiences mode, which we talked about in the Cooper S episode. Do appreciate the volume knob. That's fantastic. Well done. But I'd love to be able to tune the radio. For example, I listen to satellite radio often. I'd love to be able to tune that a little bit easier, change channels a little bit easier. But the way the system works, it can be challenging, especially when you're on the move. In terms of spaciousness, this is the biggest of the Mini. Mini, so it is voluminous for a Mini. And I think you can easily handle a young family of four. You know, let's say you live in a big city like I do. You could easily handle the daily driving needs for a young family of four with us. There's a generous amount of space, certainly in this front row. We've got a dedicated armrest that doesn't do anything except support your elbow. There's a decent amount of room in the second row as well, and I can kind of fit comfortably behind myself in the seating position. I think that second row is best used for smaller human beings, that's for sure, and there is a decent amount of room under the hatch as well.
With 51 cubic feet of cargo space, it's less Mini and more Many, as in many things can fit in here. It's like Mary Poppins' bag, but with a better suspension.
What I dig about this Countryman is the form factor, and even though there's a lot of room inside on the outside, it's still small enough that you can park it anywhere, it fits anywhere, and it's a fantastic city car, that's for sure. And on top of it, it looks stunning in urban environments. The styling of this thing is very interesting, and the details of this design make it very special, very distinctive in a sea of boring crossovers.
This is for people who want the Mini experience, but also need to occasionally transport something larger than a smartphone. It's for those who think regular Minis are cute, but want something that won't get lost in a mall parking lot.
Now, in terms of performance, this engine has lots of torque, and that's what it's meant to do. It's a modern four-cylinder turbo, and it makes lots of torque way down low in the rev range, making this very, very responsive. Mated to the dual-clutch gearbox, works extremely well, just like in the Cooper S. I'd love some shift paddles here, because from time to time, I do want to control the gearbox. On the other hand, just like with the Cooper S, the gearbox here seems to anticipate what I want, but also the fact that it's got a tremendous amount of torque helps the whole situation, because you're never really waiting for this gearbox to shift and drop a couple of gears. There's a tremendous amount of torque, so acceleration is always available. On the other hand, we do have to talk about the all-wheel drive system, and because this is front-wheel drive architecture here, I do find this does have some front drive behavior from time to time. For example, if I'm asking for a lot of acceleration very quickly, what I do find is that there's a little bit of a delay, just a fraction of a second, just a hint of it, before that torque gets to the rear axle. So what happens initially is that all that power seems to be going through the front wheels to the ground, and you get a little bit of torque steer from time to time, but that is only in extreme situations. Otherwise, it's very well behaved. And to be fair, I didn't even get a chance to drive this in any rain. When we're driving along normally and asking for power, there doesn't seem to be any issue getting all of the power to the ground through all four wheels, but I'd love to try this in the winter to see what it's like in the snow. In terms of handling, there's one way to describe it, and that's fun. And not in a hardcore sort of hot hatch kind of way, but just in a fun, delightful day-to-day driving situation. It's comfortable, it's responsive, dynamically it's enjoyable to drive, and it's very easy to deal with. So in terms of steering, very responsive, strong on center. I suppose these low profile tires and these big wheels definitely help the responsiveness on turn in, but I love how strong it is on center and love the responsiveness of the steering. Not a lot of feel or feedback comes through the steering. In terms of braking, very, very positive. And of course, I drive in Toronto, so there's always poor driving going on. I've had to use the ABS in this Countryman, and it works flawlessly. Strong brakes, very powerful, no issues there. In terms of handling, you've got a wonderful mixed bag of capability in the corners as well as overall ride comfort. And we're at highway speeds now, and it's still very quiet in here, very comfortable as well. Only the biggest of the potholes really intrude to the cabin. It does a great job soaking up bumps, and for a very simple kind of non-high-tech adaptive damper system, we've got very straightforward dampers, great body and wheel control as well. And overall, the ride and handling package, very comfortable, capable in the corners. And like I said from the beginning of this segment, it's very pleasing on a day-to-day basis, as a Mini should be.
How do you spec yours? Well, first of all, you're looking at smoky green with a silver roof and mirrors. The interior is vintage brown and it's Vexin, which is Mini's synthetic leather. Base price in the US is $38,900. And as tested, this is $42,700. In Canada, it's $45,990 base. And as tested, this is $53,890. And these prices are before freight and local taxes. This one's essentially equipped with all options except the adaptive dampers and a tow hitch. But one thing you shouldn't forget is that there is a John Cooper Works Countryman available. At this price point, it's not cheap, but neither is your coffee habit. What you get is essentially a German-engineered, British-branded lifestyle statement that's more practical than your five-year plan.
In terms of speccing yours, I think it's a matter of choosing the colors inside and out that you would like. The trouble I have with this spec with these optional massive wheels, because I do live in a city with terrible roads, I'd want to go with a smaller diameter wheel, give myself a chance to deal with some potholes and all the other nonsense on our roads and have a little bit more sidewall protection here. But otherwise, I do like these wheels. These are absolutely stunning, but I like a little bit more sidewall protection. These would have me nervous as an owner, but the wheels are stunning. And if your roads are not nasty like mine, I'd get these wheels. This is just a stunning combination. And everybody who's seen this Countryman is like, wow, what is that? And that's because they've done a fantastic job with the design and the color choices, both inside and out. My verdict, well, let's start with fuel consumption because that is going to be important to a lot of Mini buyers. I'm averaging about 25 miles per gallon in mixed city and highway driving. I think I can get better mileage if I weren't so excited about using the throttle all the time, but alas, I do enjoy driving. Nonetheless, I'd love to hear from some 2025 Countryman owners what your real world mileage is like, because I think I could do better. That said, what I really dig about this Countryman, styling, form factor, this interior is stunning and voluminous. And overall, the design of this Mini adds a lighthearted, delightful experience to daily driving.
This new Countryman ALL4 is what happens when Mini grows up but refuses to become boring. It's like your friend who got a proper job but still has a tattoo peek out during business meetings. It's more practical, more capable, and more premium, but still somehow manages to be more Mini than ever, even if the Mini part is now somewhat ironic.
And instead of buying a boring, bland crossover, if you're looking for something interesting that makes a compelling case for something that can handle daily driving as well as weekend road trips, look no further than this Mini Countryman. I am sure it'll paint a smile on your face every day, as it has every day I've driven this 2025 Countryman. Thanks for hanging out with me today and having a look at this 2025 Mini Countryman ALL4. Hope you liked this episode, and if you did, you're not new. You know what to do. Smash the subscribe button, turn on your notifications, like this. And as always, sharing is caring, so please share this with your friends, especially on Reddit, because on Reddit, they really need to see reviews for drivers from drivers. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comments below. We'll get back to you as soon as I can. And if you want to support the channel, please hit up our merch store. Links here, links below. Lots of great stuff for driving enthusiasts like us, including a very popular line of Save the Manuals merch. Thanks again for watching. We'll see you again next time. And remember, cars don't understeer by themselves, not even Mini Countrymans.